I have a spoiler alert for you. Every single human obesity study you will ever look at, ever at all, period, in the history of medical literature, the more protein people ate, the better, always, completely. Like, there's no exceptions. But we'll just talk about some anyway. Here's an ad lib obesity study, 12% versus 25% protein. Of course, the high protein group crushes the low protein group. Look at the intra-abdominal fat going down on the high protein group. Here's 1.6 grams per kilo versus 0.8 grams per kilo. The high protein group lost 53% more body fat on the same number of calories. What? I thought it was all about calories. Well, it's clearly not about protein calories. Okay, here's a study, ad lib human obesity study, 15% versus 30%. Of course, the high protein group just crushes the low protein group. They lost way more weight, way more fat, and had lower hunger scores the entire time, which is pretty magical. 16% versus 27%, of course, the high protein group wins. This is an interesting study. They took pregnant women, tracked their macros, and ultrasounded the amount of abdominal fat on their fetuses. And they did this because we have an epidemic of gestational diabetes and fetal macrosomia and C-sections in babies being too fat. Sure enough, there's a carbohydrate effect. The more carbs you eat, the fatter your fetus is. There's almost no fat effect at all. The fattest and the thinnest fetuses were at about 40% fat. That's starting to look familiar, right? And then it's all about the protein. There's just a huge linear protein association where the higher the protein, the thinner your fetus was, and the lower the protein, the fatter your fetus was in a purely linear fashion. And if you eat a high protein diet, even your offspring comes out ripped and jacked with a six pack, pretty much.